Hello, this is Egomaniac, and welcome back to Kenzan. Last time, Majima kidnapped Haruka right out of the Tsuruya, and so we are off to Kiyomizudera to rescue her. Now, everything is still open and available at this point, all of the shops, and most of the bounties and side quests for this chapter are only available now at night. And it's unfortunate, because as you can tell from the music, this is a momentous part of the story. The momentum is so much that you just want to get on with it, but if you want to finish everything, you really need to take a lengthy detour. You're running out of time to catch up in later chapters. So I've been using the lucky beads that we got from opening all the coin lockers, because I don't want to do random encounters anymore, and that helps a lot to keep us fresh for this battle, because there is, of course, going to be a battle. So yes, this is another action stage, as we usually get at the end of chapters, and it's one of the most fun because by now we actually have so many moves, I mean other than our heat actions. And the dual sword style is really coming into its own at this point. We learned a couple of things for it that come in useful, and with its speed, well, you can see why it's the main style of the game, so to speak. You probably have seen the map pop up in the bottom left off and on a lot of times during this LP. It's on by default, but I don't like it. It covers a lot of the screen, and I don't really need it because the areas aren't too huge. But it's the L3 button, so as I'm trying to move or dodge, I tend to accidentally click it a lot. It's kind of annoying, but something they still haven't fixed even up through Yakuza 4, if I'm remembering correctly. So when we first came here back in Chapter 4, I talked a little bit about Kiyomizudera, but I'll go into a little more detail this time. It is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. It covers over 130,000 square meters and about 36 buildings. And it's about 1,200 years old, although it's burned down several times throughout the centuries. It's always been rebuilt in the same style. And the most recent rebuilding was in the middle of the 17th century, so a few decades after this game takes place, which was taken care of by the third Tokugawa shogun. Kiyomizudera is built on Mount Otowa, and the real approach to it, unlike the forest road that we took to get here in this game, is a very long, steep incline on narrow roads choked with shops that sell yatsuhashi, which is a kind of local delicacy and symbol of Kyoto. It is a, well, rice paste, if it's raw, and a cinnamon sugar treat, usually with anko, red sweet bean paste, inside of it. And they also have it cooked so it winds hard, like a cracker or a cookie. It's delicious, and if you're ever in Kyoto, you should really try it, unless you hate cinnamon, because it's not really sold anywhere else. I mean, almost every region in Japan has its own local delicacy that is strangely not sold outside of that area. So the only other way to get it would be to order it online. You can actually get about as close as Kiryuu is right here now without buying a ticket to get into Kiyomizudera. And if you want to go up to the top to the viewing platform, of course you do have to pay. But it's just a few hundred yen, it's not terribly expensive. The building straight ahead in the shot right now is actually the Deva Gate, the main entrance, and Deva is a Buddhist deity of protection. There are two statues of them, one on either side, which is something you commonly see in Buddhist temples in Japan. If you don't catch that arrow, it does about a quarter of that, even that long health bar of Kiryuu's, so you do want to get it. Of course, the non-QTE arrows aren't nearly so damaging. So yes, buildings like this, historic buildings, tend to burn down in Japan. I can't think of too many that haven't. Well, probably all of them have, actually. That's because, of course, the buildings, temples, and even today most houses in Japan are wooden and fire-prone. Alright, you can't get through there with weapons, but fortunately some Deus Ex Machina is here to help us out. So I'm not sure what kind of construction there's supposed to be going on in the game, and I'm also kind of wondering where all the monks are when all these bandits and stuff are occupying their temple. Eh, whatever. Alright, so we get a bomb. Like the text says, it replaces your up slot, which is greatsword, kodachi, or other, like the jutsu. And you can only use one at a time. When you push up, he sets it wherever you're standing, so you can't, like, equip it and then move it around or anything. That's important advice, too. Voila! So, as I was saying, yes, things are built with wood in Japan, and like I said, that makes them fire-prone. One reason to use wood is it is, or it was at least, a little cheaper, of course, than using something more permanent like stone. And people in Japan and in a lot of Asian countries tend not to like used homes for various reasons. One is just taste. Another is that belief in vengeful ghosts is more widespread even in modern Japan than it is in, say, the United States. And another is that, well, form is more important than the material or the original structure. This more applies to ancient buildings, temples, and the like. But you can take, for example, the head Shinto shrine in Miyaken, Isejingu, which is rebuilt actually every 20 years to be completely identical, but most people would still consider that a very ancient building. It's not important that the wood itself be ancient, but it's more important that the form is maintained, the tradition is maintained. So enemies will jump down behind us from time to time. They are all scripted though, so I know where they are already. And there, you can see some of these stone pillars sitting around. You can blow those up with bombs too, if you want, but there's not, like, anything hidden in there or anything like that. The bombs can also hurt us and hurt the enemies, and they can break these wooden pillars. The wooden ones, though, are pillars, barricades, I mean. The wooden barricades can also be broken with the greatsword, just like any other point in the game, but the greatsword sucks, and I don't want to use it unless it's absolutely necessary. So when the first foreman told us to be wary of fire, he means the arrows, of course. If you are shot with an arrow while you're carrying a bomb, you will explode. It'll hurt you, and it'll hurt enemies that are standing really, really close to you, but it doesn't have a lot of range on it. It's not exactly an instant KO or anything, but it does kind of suck. I don't believe that getting stabbed with a sword will set it off, though. And you can see that even for bandits, these guys are a lot more aggressive than the earlier ones, like in Chapter 5 when we fought Shishido in his cave. They tend to lock us down a little more, like I tried to do that dual sword counterattack there, but since they were still continuing their combo, I had to block again. It stopped me from pulling it off. Actually, the developers of this series visited Kiyomizudera for research, and there's a picture of Naguchi Toshihiro, the producer and director of most of these games, floating around on the internet of him posing in front of the temple, but of course more of it was the level designers and the artists who came here. Although this is a famous place to literally everybody in Japan, it's probably the most famous site in Kyoto. These are just fodder enemies, but what really slows us down here is having to keep running back and getting these bombs. This won't be the last time either. Unfortunately, the bombs don't have, like, a fuse or timer or anything like that, so you can carry it as long as you want. I'm always going to go for the archers first, just because they can interrupt your combos more than if they really do damage to you. And we got some hand-to-hand guys here too, which may seem like, well, the weak enemies, but they're actually probably the ones you need to be most careful of. They will actually counter Kiryuu in a way that the others don't. And we also got a big club guy who he hits hard, but he's slow, just like Kiryuu is if he uses a great sword. So we just want to avoid him and take care of him last, or nearly last. For the hand-to-hand enemies, it's always better to try to take them on with hand-to-hand. They won't counter punches and throws, but if you try to stab at them, they'll grab Kiryu's arm and throw him for pretty serious damage. Surprisingly, more damage than getting stabbed does. Now you probably noticed the rectangular pool that I ran through several times down in that flat area. Today, actually you can see it in the background here too, there's a waterfall that cascades over a kind of a covered walkway. It's bigger in real life, but it has three separations in it. You can see falling into the water right now. And people will go there, or go to Kiyomizudera for that purpose. That's nearly as famous as the viewing platform, actually. It is, each of those three streams is supposed to represent love, longevity, and academic success. So if you drink from one of them, you will have that gift. But the legend goes that if you drink from more than one, you'll fail in all of them. You don't want to be too greedy, after all. And the name of Kiyomizudera, which means the pure water temple, comes from this. It is actually sourced from a natural waterfall, or at least it was originally. I am not 100% sure that it still is. What with, you know, global warming and development and all. But anyway, yes, if you ever go there, especially during tourist season, there will be a long, long, long line of people waiting to get in, and a lot of students on school trips if you're in the fall or the spring. And here we are desecrating it by just running right through it in our shoes and everything. Yeah, the hand-to-hand guys really just don't know what to do against the Gion unarmed style, do they? Alright, down to the last one. You always handle these guys the same way, wait till they finish their set, and then do a combo on him. This guy, his window is just a little too small, but most of them you can run up and do the dual sword 4-hit combo where he stabs them through the gut with both and picks them up and throws them, which is my very favorite. So now the way back is unlocked, which is good because we have another unbreakable barrier we'll need a bomb for. So the grounds, as they're depicted in the game, are really pretty accurate. They're a little smaller than real life, not quite to scale, and of course there's no construction and stuff here. There's actually shaved ice shops and tea houses and stuff set up along this path in the summer, and it's grassier too. Or maybe mossier, I should say. There tends to be more moss in Kyoto than grass. Fortunately, this should be our last bomb for this area. We could have just stuck another carpenter or something around here. It would have been nice instead of having this pointless backtracking when there's not even anything to attack you. I don't always get that guy, because the one-button QTEs like that are randomized, but the long set QTEs, like for the special heat actions and, well, for any of the heat actions, they are fixed. All the games in the series are fixed until Yakuza 4, which actually did randomize, like, the revelations and stuff. Which is unfortunate, because, frankly, I'm not that good at timing or rhythm or that kind of thing, so I never get it on the first try anymore. We're almost to the platform, and I like this shot because this is actually is to scale. It's quite accurate. This is the path you will take. Actually, when you leave the platform, you usually enter from the other side. And since the boss is coming up, we are gonna use some of that junk we picked up. Why not? Not sure we'll need it, but it pays to be safe.
シシド。おお。ようやく来たんか。キリュウちゃん。いや、武蔵ちゃん。お前、遥かをどうした？あっちや。おじさん。遥か。あんたとサシで会うには、こないなことするしかなかっただけや。真島お前、ついに思い出したんだな。 せや、鶴屋であの遊女に会うた後、全部思い出したわ。どうしてわしがここにおって、どうして左目が見えんのかもな。そうか。なら、俺とのことも。ま、真島、どうして？それはこっちのセリフやで。武蔵ちゃんよ。何を言ってるんだ。 俺とお前は戦う理由がないはずだ。それが終わりやねん。説明しろ、真島。浮世。浮世のことや。浮世だと？わしはあんたに浮世のことを頼んだぜ。それがどういうことやねん。真島、それは。
わしは浮世とあんたには幸せになってほしかったんや。それやのになんで。真島、確かに俺は浮世を守りきれなかった。だがそれは、
なんで浮世が遊郭で働いとんねん。浮世
が、わしが知っとる浮世は、あないな場所で働く女とちゃうわ。お前が浮世のことそそのかして働かせとるやろが。
違う。聞いてくれ、真島。違うも減ったくれもなく。キリュウちゃんいいや、ちゃう。武蔵ちゃん。ああ、もうややこしいわ。どっちでもええ。とにかくお前が浮世のこと遊郭に売り飛ばしたんやろが。違う。違うんだ。お前にも大切な人間、おもちゃにされる気持ち味わわせたる。
おじさん、どうして？
いくらお前が俺の親友でも、こいつに手を出すことだけは許さねえ。ほう、ようやくやる気になったようやな。 俺はどうしてもこいつを守ると決めたんだ。そのためなら、お前でも相手にする。そうか。それなら一丁勝負をしようが。わしが勝ったらあんたは浮世を手放す。あんたが勝ったらわしは浮世を諦める。
Well, basically, Majima is the same as he was in Chapter 5. He has a bit of a longer health bar, he hits harder, and I suppose if I was using the same weapons, he'd probably do less damage to him. But his pattern, well, he hasn't really learned any new tricks. And his fighting style is the same in pretty much all the games, as I know I mentioned before. He loves that dodge move. In fact, I think it's even animated the same in the other games. But we have learned quite a few new tricks, so you will find the dual sword style useful against him as before, because it changes direction more quickly, and it allows 360 degree blocking. And now we also have a counter for it, which he does get hit by most of the time, he fails to block it. And once in a while, or if you position yourself right, the dodge slash that we learned last time, or in the last training video, is pretty good against him too. He's immune, like most bosses, to the majority of heat actions. I mean, the majority of our standard heat actions, but we will have the opportunity to use not only the special one from Inozuma against him, but also the general dual sword style heat action, boss heat action. Yeah, if you don't try to close the gap, he won't actually come to you. And there was the boss-specific heat action for Majima. He must be in the dual sword style. You may remember, all the way back in Chapter 5, he did use that same QTE against us, but we didn't have the dual sword heat action at that time, so we couldn't trigger anything. All we could do was block it. And there was the general boss heat action. A little more brutal. Now, Majima does have one attack that we can't block. If you just try to stand in front of him and block his combo, his second one in his chain will be a leg sweep. However, we long since have learned the power-up from the waterfall training that makes us unable to be knocked down in heat mode. Or maybe actually we learned that one from Koetsu. I think it was from the dummy training, actually. Either way, unless we've used up all our heat gauge, which is almost impossible since you can't use very many heat actions against Majima, he won't ever really do any serious harm to you. It just takes a sliver off your health. One of the only new things he can do, which you've already seen, is he can climb up on those decorations and try to swing at you. But if you keep your distance, it won't hurt. So the site of this battle is actually the viewing platform I was talking about. This is the main tourist attraction, and the one that people used to jump off of in order to grant their wishes, they believed. It is 12 meters off the ground, so deaths were, if not common, certainly not rare. It is actually to scale in the game, and the main hall is right behind where Haruko is chained up here. But this is always crowded, except maybe in the dead of winter.
Kiryuu no danna.
Yoshino. Omae. Masaka ashi nuke shite.
Chigau wa. Hanashi wa ato ya. Majima-san, shikkari shite. Majima-san.
Ukiyo.
Majima-san, chigau ya. Uchi wa Ukiyo ya nai. Ane no Ageha ya.
Ageha?
So. Anata ga koroshita Kozuke no kuni no kenshi. Shirai Seinoshin no musume. Ageha ya.
So ka. An toki no.
Anata ga Ukiyo o sewa shite kurete tan yaro?
Nande? Sore wo?
Ukiyo kara moratta fumi ni kaite atta. Anata to no koto ga. Masaka anata ga Ukiyo to kurashite ru to wa omowakatta.
So ka. Anta nee-chan no hou kai na. Washi no kanchigai yatta n ka. Honara Ukiyo wa ima nani o shito nne?
今も大海の国で元気にしとんのか?いや。ま、どうしたんや?浮世は4年前死んだんだ。何やと?どういうことや?俺が殺したんだ。キリュウちゃん。
旦那、あの噂、本当やったんやね。浮世を殺したのは宮本武蔵って噂、あれはほんまやったんやね。旦那やない。旦那が宮本武蔵やったとしても、浮世を殺したんはちゃう人や。そう信じてきたのに。吉野。
なんで浮世を殺した?アゲハちゃん、そらちゃうで。せやろ?キリュウちゃん。あんた、関ヶ原の時みたいに、またはめられたんやろ?ああ。俺は、浮世を守ることができなかったんだ。え?あの時俺は、 追われていた。徳川、そして賞金稼ぎの連中に。浮世は俺を守るため、そいつらの犠牲に。
え、ほんなら旦那が浮世を切ったわけじゃ。
吉野、この俺の剣についている鈴は 浮世がつけてくれたものだ。 俺が再び剣を取った時のお守りとして、 俺はお前に初めて会った時から、 お前が浮世の姉だと思っていた。 だが今まで本当のことを話せなかった。 許してくれ。
ようやく終わったか。飛んだ茶番劇だな、佐々木小次郎。始終見せてもらった関ヶ原から続く感動話、涙が出そうだったぞ。<笑>貴様。 おっと、状況をよく見てみるんだな。この娘が死んでもいいのか。
くそ。
しかし本当にバカな連中だ。お前もせっかく自由の身にしてやったというのに、こんなところで何をしているのだ。
え？どういう意味だ。
鶴屋の火事を覚えているだろう。俺はこの女の自由と引き換えに火をつけさせた。この女はすでに身請けされた自由の身なのだ。
そうか。だからお前、祇園を出てこれたのか。
だというのに、なぜお前はまだ祇園にいるんだ。とっとと逃げてればいいものを。
それは
宮本武蔵が気になったからか。
そうや。うちは旦那が本当に浮世を殺したんかどうか確かめる必要があったんや。
一度は金に目をくらませた遊女のセリフとは思えんな。
小次郎、お前。
ええんや旦那、その通りなんやから。確かにあの時のうちはどうかしてた。自由の身になれると思って店に火をつけた。せやけど分かったんや、あんたみたいな男に金で身請けされても意味がないってことに。
折れたのか、この男に。
そうや、うちはこの人のおかげで目が覚めたんや。金なら返す、そしてうちは祇園に残る。
吉野、お前。
まあよい、あとはこの娘を始末しさえすれば俺の任務は全て終わる。
何をする。
5年前お前に切られた左目の借り返させてもらうで。
この死に損ないが。
マジマ、
マジマさん、
マジマ。
5年前を見ているようだな、宮本武蔵よ。
小次郎、貴様、
しばし待て。この勝負わしが預かる。
なぜあなたがここに。
この娘を斬ることは許さん。お主もそれは分かっておるな。お主の立場も分かる。じゃがここはわしの顔を立てて素直に帰ってくれ。
分かりました。
待て、逃げるのか小次郎。
お前も一度俺の前から逃げたはずだ。改めてお前と戦う日まで勝負はお預けだ。ごめん。
おお、かわいそうに。今助けてやるからな。
ちょっと待てよ。
ん？
あんた一体何なんだ。遥かを身請けすると言ったかと思えば小次郎とまでつながってる。
俺たちをどんだけ振り回せば気が済むんだよ。
よし、これでよい。
おい、聞いてんのかクソじじい。あんたがもっと早く来ていれば、真島も死なずに済んだんだ。
そうだな、お主の言う通りじゃ。わしはちょっと遅すぎたのじゃ、全てにおいて。
なんだと。
全てのことを話そう。わしとお春のこと、そして佐々木小次郎の全てを。
全て。
お主に全てを聞く勇気があればの話だが。
わかった。話を聞こう。
ならば明日、祇園の大門前に使いの者をよこす。その者たちと一緒にわしのところへ来い。よいな。
ああ。